So now we are moving forward. Oh my God. Okay, now we are moving forward. Okay, after. Okay, guys. Now, if anyone has my essay, if you complete my essay, you can share with me. If anyone has done, just let me know.
I have one question about your essay.
Yes.
I'm a bit confused about the main question, main topic. Yeah. The question was, in some countries, more and more people are becoming interested in finding out about the house or building they live in. But here, in the first paragraph,
for living,
you said that they are like looking human brain. It is becoming popular in the human brain that they are looking historical building for staying. So this is stating that they are looking for a historical building there for staying. But in the
yes.
question,
they're living.
It was said they're already living in and
exactly.
they are trying to find out about the history of the building that they live in, their ancestral
yes.
home or anything, that building or the flat. What's the history behind that?
I agree with you. I did that mistake. I used for instead of for. I have to use like they live in. I have to in this.
Okay.
It was my mistake.
Okay, so the meaning completely changes.
Yes, when I use for, then meaning is changed. But if I use in, then it will be okay.
I mean, the essay is like explaining totally why people are looking for a historical place to live in, or why before choosing a place to live in, why people are investigating the history of that place. But the question was totally different because it's stating that about the place they're currently living in, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah, you're right. You're absolutely right. I don't have any comments about your statement because you're right. But my body one and two, I think.
I haven't read that. So first, when I read the first paragraph, I got really confused. That's why I asked you to be
no,
clear.
Like
there.
I said at the beginning, like when I was sharing my feedback with Ankita, I said I did a mistake.
Okay.
When I was sharing my feedback with Ankita, then I realized what I did.
Okay.
Like I wrote over there like four there instead of four. I have to write in. That would be okay in order. That would be okay for me. I think my body one and two. I think those are okay. You can roll again. You can
yeah.
read it.
Okay, I'm reading it.
Yeah.
Okay, I have already read it.
Yes,
so
yes. Go on.
In first paragraph, you stick to the main introduction, like you want to find the place where you are looking for staying. So in the first paragraph one, you mentioned that like people are searching for popular places that you said me in my feedback. So yeah, that idea you wrote, right?
Yes.
So it relates to the introduction, not to the question.
I didn't get you. What did you say?
I'm saying that your introduction relates to that body paragraph, but not to the question. Like in the question, they already mentioned that the house you are already living,
yeah.
right? But you
yeah.
are in your
yeah.
body paragraph one, you are saying that people are searching popular places, like they want to move on to that places because they just want to be a famous or
yes,
like
yes, I agree with you. When I used for everywhere, I made that mistake, mind. Yeah, I agree with you. I
yeah,
have to use
so,
like for instead of using like yeah, in. I have to use in, the late in.
Yeah.
You're right,
Yes,
you're right.
I totally agree with Ankita here.
Yes, you're right.
I read the two paragraph and
Yes.
it's based on your introduction.
Exactly.
I mean,
I agree.
it's all right if the question was that.
Yes, I agree with you. I don't know why I did that mistake. Oh my God, okay. I when I was writing, I felt like, okay, for living, okay. Anyways, I didn't check like the live in. I feel like, okay, for living, okay. Just single time I read the question and I was trying to write. To be honest, I didn't read the question when I was typing. To be honest, I didn't focus about the question and I was just typing with the word like a WAD word or blah, 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 blah. I was typing with the word. I didn't read the question.
When I read the question, I was so confused about the answer. If you read my answer, it's totally, it's like a little kid wrote it. And I was really confused what to write because this topic is, it's unique. Why would I want to know about the history of the building I'm living in?
Okay, anyways, I have one thing. I have one thing. Yeah, we'll begin with you. I have one thing. If we speak about for living, then is it okay?
Yes, I found it very much, what can I say, to the point. If it's for living, your paragraphs are to the point and it have reasoning that why it is important to know the history of a place that someone want to live in, and you have also used examples like for instance and for example in Canada, also in America. I like the first example in first paragraph. It was it showed some humor, and there's the second paragraph, for instance, in Canada, famous country about historical places. This one is good as well. Yes, I think your paragraphs were logical to the topic you about.
Okay, so if we consider rather than in with four, like if we consider with four, then it would be okay, right?
Yes, I think it would be okay. It's good.
Same here. I'm also thinking the same way.
Okay, so it would be okay if I if we consider four.
Yes, definitely.
Thank you very much. So I did the mistake about in or with four. I didn't check the question and I just read for a single time. Okay, this is the question. Okay, let's begin. Because I feel like I would never able to cover the question. Like
so it's a huge thing that to think of it like a simple preposition can change a totally meaning of a question.
Exactly, you're right. It's happened with me. Okay, anyways, thank you very much. So again, we are moving forward to Calvalin. Hi, Calvalin, what do you think about my statement? Please consider in with four. If you consider four, then what's your opinion? Calvalin, can you hear me? Are you with us?
I'm still reading your statement.
Should I read? Should I need to help you? Should I need to help you?
Oh, I can read your statement. I can read your statement well.
Okay. So my handwriting. Okay, anyways, guys, what's about my handwriting? Is it dancing?
I don't think so. They're I wouldn't say they're very good, but I can read everything. So
okay. One of our friend in this group, and those guys were saying, maybe you have to change your handwriting. Your handwriting looks like dancing.
No, I think it's fine. It's better than mine, so I can't complain.
Okay. So we are waiting for. Okay, in between, guys, I'm requesting to read another statement, which is after me. We have another statement here. I'm just waiting for Calvin. So in between, here is Ankita. I'm requesting to you, please read Navin's statement, and we'll begin with you. And Nafisa, I'm requesting to you also read his statement. We'll begin with you guys. With your okay. feedback, from your feedback. So. Yeah, I'm okay. just waiting for Calvin. Hi, Calvin. Do you have anything else you can share with me about my statement?
Actually, your statement is quite interesting and good. All of the words that you use is fine. And I agree with Nazifa. Same as what she said.
Okay, I did mistake with fall. It was my mistake. It was not like a little mistake, it was huge. It's a big mistake. And that in this extent, I could lose my score. I could lose my score. It would be 5.5 essay. It would be 5.5 essay. Not like 6 points. I would lose my score. Anyways, thank you very much, guys, for sharing your feedback with me. I have to improve a lot. Thank you very much. Now we are moving forward. We have another statement. We have here Navid. Hi, Navid. Ro, can you hear me?
Hello. Yes, I can hear you.
You didn't read my statement.
Yes, I didn't read.
Okay, bro. Next day, inshallah.
Yes, of course. I will fix the issue after the call.
Yes, bro. Thank you very much. So now we're going to share our feedback. And I'm requesting to anyone, just let me know if anyone has done.
Hello.
Yes, go on. Ankita. Hi, Ankita.
Yeah. In introduction, you have to paraphrase the question. You just wrote about like some slogans and another thing. You really don't have to mention that thing in the introduction.
Okay.
Yeah. And I will show why and how people approach to the history of how they dwell in. Yeah. Why I will. We cannot say like directly in the essay, I will. This essay will discuss, or this essay will indicate. You can say anything, but you cannot say directly I will, because it's like a formal thing. You cannot say informally I will do this. Yeah.
Okay.
Hope you get it.
Yes, I get it. So what should I write instead of I will? Can you please have any idea?
This essay will discuss, as already I think someone wrote this thing in the essay. I really didn't remember the name.
It was this essay will address.
This essay will discuss. Also, okay, you also say that this essay will discuss reason.
I wrote. This essay will explain the matter of the fact.
Yeah.
And the way which could help them for investigating.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And what about the size of the length of the introduction? Is it okay?
Yeah, length is not the problem, because in introduction, we have to write only two or three sentences, not more, much more than. So length is not the problem, but the quality of like writing quality should be there. Yeah. So you have to paraphrase the question. Do not write anything more than that. Yeah.
Okay. What about the second and third paragraph? I know that I am running out of my time, so I didn't complete it.
Yeah, because in 30 minutes we have to just brainstorming the ideas, and we have to write all the things in 30 minutes. 30 minutes is very late. 30 minutes we cannot structure the essay and write all the things.
Yes, this is the challenge. 30 minutes is challenging, but we have to complete it within 30 minutes. We have to complete.
For me, it's real struggle. Because,
yeah, to be honest, not only you, we all are struggling. But if you check our previous statement, like most of the person in our team, they were able to complete within 30 minutes. Might within 25 minutes, they could complete. And Cambridge said, 25 minutes enough to write and to complete your task too. And they are shaving 15 more because as you are not a native speaker, as you are not native contributor, that 15 minutes more to identify the answer, find out the way to write, and to find out your errors. That's why they are providing 15 minutes more. And Cambridge recommend you can read Cambridge statement in any Cambridge books, Cambridge Arts books. They already mentioned in writing part 25 minutes. They already price like how much separate area, and they said like 25 minutes is good enough to complete the whole essay. That's why we are covering like 30 minutes to complete our essay. If they could, then why we are not? As a human being, if we train up our mind, then definitely we can do it.
Yes, sure. And hopefully we will get through this group to complete it.
I hope like we have to make our spread like why we come. Definitely we can. If they can, as a native person, if they can, then why we come? This isn't language. This is a language. This is not like any rocket. This is not like any missile we have to launch. Just put the button and launch the mission. It's not like that. We can learn and we can definitely do it. If we are really serious, we can do it. Okay, anyways, I'm sorry. So Ankita, do you have anything else?
Yeah. In the first paragraph, you wrote antique houses. Antique house is not proper collocation, I think, because we cannot say antique houses. We can say heritage houses, heritage buildings, but not antique houses. Anyone say like I'm right or wrong?
Yeah, you're right. Antique should use for stuff.
Yeah, antique ornaments, antique jewelry.
Yeah, antique should use for stuff, not for house, for any living space.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, otherwise your point is really good because I haven't thought about it. Actually, you make a good point here. Yeah, we can make money from the houses by, yeah. And why you make third paragraph? Because it's a reason, yeah? So you have to write in paragraph one only. But you just,
Okay, I think that my second paragraph is the first reason and the third paragraph is the second reason. And
no.
After that,
I think in paragraph one, you have to mention all the reasons, and in paragraph three, in paragraph two, you have to mention about the ways how you can do research, how people can do research, and the conclusion, only four paragraphs.
So, okay, in total, there will be four paragraphs.
Yeah.
Okay, it's completely fine.
Yeah, but here the point is really good for making money. Yeah.
Okay, that's all?
Okay, that's all. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you very much, Ankita, for sharing your opinion. And Ankita, I have one request. Please read next statement, which is provided by Nazifa. We'll back to you first. So here I'm again moving forward to Nazifa. Hi, Nazifa. Do you have any comments about Navid?
Yes, I have. I actually like his introduction statement. I think it totally goes with the question. But the way Ankita told that he wrote, "I will show you," that can be better. And in the first second paragraph, I got the point he wanted to make, that people want to like know the history of the building they live in to like sell it to another person for making profit. But I got the point after Ankita told it, but the writing is not that clear. It is the line started with, "Most people in 2 days would are looking for antique houses or buildings as they want to invest in." So why would people like, I think this sentence could be better in a way that like people are people want to know the history of their building or their home because they want to resell it or rent it to investor to make profit. So that way it would be more understandable. And in second paragraph, some people want to buy these properties as they want to have some inner satisfaction. Same thing, it was like the meaning of the sentence doesn't go with the main idea of the question. I mean the first paragraph, because the idea was why people want to know the story of the house that they're living in. So yes, I think the point is really good, that they want to resell it or invest it, but the way he wrote it, it seems like that he's writing some people just want to buy properties, or some people are interested in old-fashioned houses, these kind of things. So I think this could be more clearer.
Okay.
I personally didn't get the point first. That's why I said it.
Actually, I think I have made mistakes similar to Mehdi Hasan, that I didn't get the statement. Like, I think that the houses we are looking for. So based on this statement, I have write this essay that they want to invest to earn money. And the second paragraph is also that they want to have some satisfaction to buy the luxury homes.
But in first paragraph, you said it so nicely, that because human beings believe in stories rather than the facts, figures and equation. I like this line a lot, because I think in my paragraph, I wrote this same thing over and over again in simple words, that yes, human beings always try to learn new things and learn about their ancestor roots, how the house was built and stuff. So at the first paragraph, it was good and it was in line with the question, but in second and third paragraph I got really confused.
Yes, actually the first paragraph I have learned from YouTube that you have to write very general idea, and I take this that human believes in story. I have read this in the summary of some books, so I have remembered this, so that's why I it came to my mind and eventually I wrote it here. And
you have paraphrased the word as well, sentence as well. There are people in some countries who takes more interest about historical background of the building or house they live in. Here you write live in, because so it goes with the question, but in second and third paragraph it somehow got a bit messed up maybe.
Yeah, sure. I can completely understand it. Otherwise, thank you very much for your feedback, Nazifa.
You're most welcome.
Thank you very much, Nazifa, for sharing your opinion. Again, we are moving forward to Kelvin. Hi, Kelvin. Do you have any comments about Navid? Kelvin, can you hear me? She's unable to speak. Anyways, finally it comes to me. Hi, okay. Navid. Yeah, hi. Hi, Brooke, can you hear me?
Yeah, yes, I can hear you.
Okay, thank you very much, Navid. So let's begin with your introduction. There are people in some countries who takes more interest, about the historical background of the building or house they live in, because human beings in stories, right?
Yes, human beings believe in story.
Human beings believes in stories rather than facts. Then you use figures.
Yes.
Figures
what? Equation.
And the stories, and the shorter the story, the better it is. In this essay, I will show why and how people approach to the history of houses they to learn in. Okay, fine. Okay. There are people in some countries who takes more interest about the historical background of the building or house they live in. Because human beings. Okay, I don't have any complaint. Your paraphrasing area and all the Ankita mentioned about here, I will show why and how people approach to the historical and housing the dealing. So I don't have any complaint, because already Ankita mentioned to you, most people in today's world. So you have. In today's world, I think you are facing problem with singular and plural, with your preposition. Your at the beginning, I feel like people are plural, right? People are plural.
Okay.
People are plural part. People are plural. Human are singular. Humans are plural. Public are plural. Person is singular. So as you're gonna write people in some countries, who takes would be wrong here, because this is plural. It would be verb. This is the verb. Take is a verb. It should be singular. it would be take. It would take more interest, and not like take more interest. They are becoming more interested. They are becoming more interested with a passive voice. They are becoming more interested about the historical background of the building or house they live in. Here, this sentence in order. But the fact is here after this, because human beings, this is plural, believe. Human being is believe that. So this sentence structure is here, believe in stories. Believe in stories rather than facts. Believe in stories, beliefs. That should be believe in stories. I don't know. No. You are right. Believe in stories rather than facts. Then comma, figure or what you wrote here, your introduction here.
Figures or equations?
No. I'm just trying to understand the meaning here. Like figure of equation, what do you mean?
Like people are more interesting in the stories that are related to the historical backgrounds of the buildings.
Okay. So you are explaining more. I don't have anything, okay. And the stories, then the shorter the story, the better it is in this essay. So in this area, in your introduction area, you didn't explain the background statement, right? You are trying to explain the background statement with your own way, but it already changed the meaning. So it's already changed the meaning. So you can do anything, whatever you want, but you have to pay attention. We shouldn't change the meaning. If you're gonna change the meaning of the question, then you will lose your marks, because introduction would never create any value in your essay. But if you're gonna change, it would be face of your body of your essay, and definitely it would be important. It would become important in your writing task too. And pay attention your paraphrasing area. If you're gonna change the meaning, then it would create the problem for you.
Okay.
Let's begin with your body one. Most people in today's, this is okay, but I prefer, for me, I would write nowadays or the demand. Okay, guys, one thing. Nowadays and plethora, both words are banned from Cambridge. So don't try to use those words if you have this list. Nowadays and plethora.
Nowadays and
plethora.
Plethora. Okay, we will not use that.
Nowadays and would you please plethora. Repeat?
Plethora.
Later on. Okay.
No, plethora.
Oh, plethora. Okay, plethora. Plenty of.
It means a lot of. Yeah, it means a lot of.
Okay.
Plethora. It means a lot of, and nowadays it's gonna represent like present situation. You can write at the present time, you can write in the present situation, and momentarily, or in the recent time, and today's, you can write those things. Most people in today's, in the world, are looking for antique house, for a building, for a building. As they want to invest in those property for earning and makes. Okay, this is again mistake here. If you're gonna write a verb before and with a ing form, then after and that verb should be again ing form. Earning and makes, not makes. Earning and making their investment double. Earning and making their investment double in a short term period. this shows terms of period, not period. Period would be not appropriate here. Show terms of period. This house often bought by, right?
Yes, by.
By the tourism, often bought by the tourism or cultural department. Bought or rained, not like bought, it's like rained. Tourist or cultural, yeah, like if you're gonna bought, then you're gonna purchase. Often bought, not like bought. This is a past form. This is bought like past form. You are speaking about present.
Okay.
Often buy. Bought is past form. Often buy. If you're gonna use this form, then you have to use buy. Often buy the tourism or cultural department of the country and what?
Declared.
What?
Declared as a the heritage site.
Declared as a heritage site. In this way, it would help those investors to gain a good profit for their investment and earn a livelihood. Okay, I think your idea is okay. I don't have any complaint with your idea. I have problem with your explanation and with your sentence structure. You have problem with your sentence structure. I hope you already understand where you have to work. You have to work about your tense area with your singular, plural, subject, verb, agreement. You have to work on. You have to work about your singular, plural area, which is related subject, verb, agreement. And you have to work about your vocabulary figure. Like, I don't know the name of this area. I don't know. I forgot. Three figure we have in vocabulary, past, present, and PP form. We have three figure. Mm-hmm. You have, I think you know all those things, but somehow might you did mistake. That's why I'm just telling you, just try to revise again. That could help you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and pay attention with your sentence structure group and punctuation as well.
Okay.
And I think you use few words with accurately. Here is often. I really appreciate you use often. You could precise with this word, like simple word, like simply. You could explain your idea often. Yeah, that's good. And avoid your low level of vocabulary. Yeah, it should be okay. You can use whatever you want. You can use, but try to avoid like a low budget word. Try to use mid budget word. That would be okay. Okay. Anyways, thank you very much. I'm not sharing any other second idea, like secondly, because that should be in order about the explanation of why people are searching, like how people could search, and that should be okay. But you are explaining like again another thing, like with second. Secondly, like why you use secondly, I didn't know. When you're going to use secondly, the first paragraph, you have to mention firstly, rather than you are unable to use secondly. Pay attention with your connector, when and where you're going to use the connector, because connector could boost your score, connector could lessen your score. Pay attention with your connector. Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you very much, bro. Now we are moving forward on a final statement. Let's begin with Ankita. Hi, Ankita. Oh my God, she left. Okay, anyways. So here is Calvin. Hi, Calvin. Oh my God. Okay, she's unable. So I have to read and I have to share my feedback. Okay, you have three statements, right? Nazifa.
Yes.
Bro, I'm done with you. So we are moving forward with Nazifa.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for your feedback.
Thank you very much, bro. Thank you very much. And I have one request. Please join us regularly. We are really tired to find our member, because if, guys, we have a regular member, then we'd never find any other member and we could begin our practice regularly. Because hunting member is really tough, and we have to find a member from different area. And as we mentioned to any, like everyone, like we never accept more than four members from the same from the same nationalities. So this is really difficult for everyone. So we have like how many members you could receive? They are not from the same countries. You would receive a lot of person here. They are from different nationalities. So anyways, here is Nazifa. Hi, Nazifa.
Hello.
So you can see we already covered 3 hours here.
Yeah, it's quite late.
Yeah, I'm so sorry for that. So let's begin with the introduction. So could you please read the introduction in your handwriting?
Yeah, sure.
In some countries, more and more people are becoming interested. Okay, this is the question.
I think the introduction.
Just let me know when I say to you, you can write. Did you write your question?
Yeah, I wrote the question.
Okay, you shouldn't write the question. Just avoid this. You have to avoid this. So what is your opinion? Like here, this is your introduction, right? We are living in a dynamic world.
Yeah.
We are living in a dynamic world where everything is evolving.
I think I made a spelling mistake.
Yeah, okay. Involving day by day, okay. Only day by day, people are becoming more aware means like far. Aware means far.
Okay, so what
aware means far, aware of everything. People are becoming more aware for everything. It has been
seen that
people are now more
enthusiastic. It's a spelling mistake.
Enthusiastic, yeah. Spelling, you pay attention with your spelling about the history of the place the living. Okay, fine. Your introduction is not right here.
Okay.
Your introduction is not right here. And you didn't explain what you're gonna do with this essay. What you're gonna do, you didn't explain. You're gonna explain the reason, and you're gonna share the sources. You didn't explain. You had to explain clearly what you're gonna do.
Okay.
That your first statement: we are living in a dynamic world. The question didn't speak about any dynamic world, like why we're gonna live. They didn't speak about all these things. They said in the recent, like in few countries. Those are the questions, right? It's in the mind. I will remember. Okay. In some countries, not this world. We are not speaking about the world. We are speaking about some countries. Definitely, they belong in this world, in this universe. But to be honest with you, like, we are unable to use, like, world in this dynamic world. This is what we can say. We are living in a dynamic world where everything is evolving, divided. Okay. This is wrong here. I don't know what you were right here. People are becoming more aware of everything. It's been so far from the beginning. People are becoming more aware. Like people are becoming more, like more far of everything. People are keeping distance from everything.
No, I wanted to write aware. They are more cautious about everything. They are
aware.
Yeah, the spelling is wrong.
Okay. So pay attention again with your spelling.
Yeah.
So your introduction is not right here. So we'd share with you how to write. Okay. How to write the introduction? You have to. I think you have idea about the introduction. Do you?
Yes, I do. But when I started writing, I just came back home and I was really tired. So I just wrote whatever came in my mind, and I forgot about all the guidelines that needed to put here.
I'm so sorry for our timing, our schedule. I'm so sorry for that. No, no,
it's my fault. I should have, I got in some work today, so I couldn't manage.
So you are working, right?
I'm an artist, so I have to deliver a painting of mine. So I got busy with that. So it.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Painter, you okay? We have a lot of to speak about you. Okay, we'll speak about you in future. Okay. Anyways, first of all, the main reason that people are more interested in the history is that people are not interested about history. They are interested about historical place and as well as building.
Yeah, not I needed to mention that.
Yeah, not history. They're not interested about any history. They are interested about historical place or building.
They live in
or the house. Okay, they want to know more, and also in also it is an
exciting thing. It's a spelling mistake.
Okay, I got you. Okay. Exciting things. Nothing. It should be things.
Things.
Because your first statement was singular here. Okay, and so the main reason. Yeah, the main reason. One reason is here. So it everything should be your
singular
verb. Yeah, your verb and everything should be singular here. The main reason that people are. That people are more interested in the historical history is that they want to know more, and also it is an exciting thing. So here you are using it is, then again you have to use here things, because this is the grammar rules. Your first statement. It's called like subject verb agreement. It's called subject verb agreement. It should be like things. Like as for Einstein. For some people are well. Okay, it's not explained. Well explained. Nazifa, right? It's not well explained.
Yes.
You have to explain. As I say to Calvin, she slept already. As I say to Calvin, you have to share. An essential idea, then you have to explain your idea.
Sorry for that. Sorry, it was my mom.
You can speak with your mom. It's okay. It's all right.
No, she was just calling me for dinner.
So, as I mentioned, I'll be able to explain your central idea first, then move forward to your explanation. Then try to support your idea with an example. That will be much clearer. That will be much more distinct.
I have a question here, but in this topic, the first they wanted to know what are the reason, and then how can people research the history and stuff. So in first topic, we're gonna explain the reason in second paragraph we're gonna explain the reason of why people want to know more about the history, and in second maybe it can be explained
the research,
the process of research. What about the third paragraph? What can we include in the third?
What do you think about third paragraph?
We need to the third paragraph can be conclusion.
Yes.
Okay, so there will be four paragraphs.
So
two body
you
paragraphs.
You are struggling with identify the questions. You have to identify the question first.
Okay.
As you say, third paragraph, then I have doubt. I have really doubt about your idea about the writing in question identification. Okay, when and where are we gonna write third paragraph, and our essay would be five paragraph. Do you have any ideas?
No, I totally don't have any idea.
So anywhere, if you receive like agree, disagree statement, like anywhere, if you're gonna receive, explain with yourself and give your own opinion. If they're gonna receive, they're gonna say to you, give your own opinion. During that time, you have to share a separate paragraph.
Okay.
Like, do you agree or disagree? Disagree question, you're gonna agree, then you have to write with two paragraphs with your agreement or disagreement and separate paragraph for your opinion. And okay. Discuss both views, especially it's happening with discussion essay. Discuss both views and give your own opinion. You're using these types of question, the discussion essay, rather than using any other.
To be clear, sorry to interrupt. I was just trying to make sense. To be clear, in agree and disagree question, I have to like explain the one paragraph with the why I agree with it or why I disagree, and then in second paragraph about the disagreement, and then in the third paragraph I have to like explain in which way I'm choosing agree or disagree.
Yes, like in your introduction you have to mention clearly you're gonna agree or disagree. If you're going to say you agree or partially agree means you agree, also disagree. And if you're going to say you agree, then you have to conduct your both paragraph with your agreement. And if you receive, give your own opinion, then you have to share your one, like you have to share your separate paragraph. I'm sorry. Okay. You have to give your own opinion with a separate paragraph.
Okay, so two paragraphs for
two paragraphs for you like agreed disagreement, and one paragraph for your opinion.
My own opinion, and there's a conclusion.
Conclusion will be four paragraph, fifth paragraph.
Introduction
is first paragraph, body one is second paragraph, body two is third paragraph, body four like your opinion would be a fourth paragraph, and your conclusion will be like fifth paragraph. But in this case, on that occasion, you would receive an advantage. That is, you shouldn't explain in detail. Just try to escape your information, like within one sentence or two sentences, clear your information and explain. And within one sentence, you can explain and just try to directly jump on the topic. Don't try to move anywhere. Don't try to sprout and sound and move and jumping in any other topics. Don't try to do that. Just try to jump on the like on topic correctly.
Just sticking to the main point.
Exactly. Just directly jump on the topic and explain your opinion. That'll be
good. In this question, there is two questions. What are the reason and how can people research this? So, what I could have done that I could have like. Explain about the reason in one paragraph, and in third paragraph I could explain about
second paragraph.
In body
like second paragraph, body paragraph.
Yes.
Body paragraph.
Okay, in body paragraph second I could have just like mention about the research and then conclusion. I tried to do that but the writings are have so many errors and spelling errors. So
it's okay. It's happened with everyone. It's not only you. You are facing this problem. It's not only you. I was having a lot of issues, to be honest with you. It took more than 8 months. It took more than 8 months. Could you realize? It took more than eight months. I'm learning. Until now, I have problem.
Okay. So I guess I need to be
concerned. I should cry. Like more than 8 months I'm practicing, until now I have problem. So I should cry right now. If you're gonna say you have problem, you are practicing.
That's amazing that you are so consistent. You shouldn't cry. I mean, you're so determined. That's a great thing. People, most of people they lost hope. For me, I've been studying for only 2 months, and my spellings are horrible, totally.
If you attend us, if you attend our seminar regularly, I hope it could help you. Okay, anyways, come back to the point again. As I was explaining about your introduction and body one, and I think like your body one is not in order, so I thought your body is not clear here. You didn't
check.
I'm going to redo the statue.
Okay.
Is it okay for you?
Yeah, yeah, sure. I have another question. In body one, I try to give an example of myself. Is it okay to provide an example from real life?
To be honest with you, a lot of person they have different opinion, and a lot of examiner they say it can mind. It doesn't require like where your explanation and where your example came from. It doesn't require, but they have one fact. Try to avoid yourself to involve the essay.
Okay.
Yeah, it will be much better.
All right.
Okay, sounds like sure. tricky sounds, but you can avoid this.
Can like say a friend of mine or someone I knew?
No. I don't think so. Not like that. Friend of mine or this is informal. In this part, you have to be patient with your form of vocabulary. You are unable to use informal any single words or any phrases. No, sorry, any idioms you're unable to use. You can use phrase, but idioms, it's not allowed.
All right, I think I need to study more about the structure and the phrases.
Okay, I'm going to share with you the structure. That would be okay for you.
That would be very helpful. Thank you so much.
So I'm not going to share the feedback because it's not in order. So you can make some notes.
Yeah, I have already taken a lot of notes from the other feedbacks.
Cool. So I think, is it okay if I'm going to share with you something?
Yeah, sure.
From the introduction or body one? Okay, from the body one. Introduction, you could overview other essays, and that would be okay. And I would share our introduction structure accurately. So at the same day, if you're going to share Hugh's thing, you would confuse. You'd never understand. So let's begin with the body one.
Okay.
So body one and body two would be the same, in order, like same structure. You could follow it.
Okay.
And first of all, you have to write a central idea, within, like your first sentence would be your central idea within one
like
sentence.
Topic sentence.
Yes, topic sentence. Your topic sentence. What are you gonna explain in this essay, in this paragraph, like body one in this paragraph? What are you gonna explain? That should be represent your body one. Your sentence, your topic sentence, or your central idea, which is called central idea. It is really famous in this world, which is central idea. Then you have to explain your idea. Explanation, your central idea explanation. Like I said, I love to drink water. Why I love to drink water? Because it makes me feel better when I work and when I'm tired, when I feel my neck is dusty, and then it makes me okay to feel better.
So it's totally to the point.
Yes, directly jump on the point. Don't try to move anywhere. Directly jump on the point.
Okay.
Explanation and support the explanation. For example, if I run very fast, for a long time, then I would lose my energy and my blood pressure would be high. During that moment, my body will earn or my body would deserve free water. So it could help me to develop my energy or encourage my energy or boost my energy gain, and I could run again and I could win the match if I'm working and if I'm having the race. That could help me.
Okay, so here you're providing supporting ideas.
Yes, your explanation, your central point, your explanation and example for your supporting example will support your central idea. Example will support your explanation.
Okay.
This is the three things you have to do.
Okay.
In your body one and body two.
Central idea, examples, and examples that support.
Central idea, explanation, and example.
Okay.
Thank you very much. I hope guys you enjoyed our seminar today. And thank you very much for joining our today's seminar. And we already covered 3.5 hours here. And after this seminar, our meeting will be published in our Facebook group. And I'm so sorry for that. We'd never share our videos in Facebook because it will take a long stories. We share in our YouTube channel. Yeah, I'm sorry. We share in our YouTube channel and we share a link in our Facebook group. Thank you very much, guys. And see you tomorrow at the same time at the same place with a lot of different writing structure. Not like having a second writing essay, writing questions. Thank you very much. And I hope it would be active in our team. Thank you very much, guys, and see you tomorrow.
You're welcome. Thank you. See you.
Thank you very much, guys. See you tomorrow. Good night.
Good night.